Mari Zelba, a.k.a. Real Housewife of Vancouver. Good to see you.
Hi, good to see you.
You're back again here on the show.
I am.
We had John when season one debuted. And season two, I got to admit, I hear a lot of hype about this. I hear about the drama. Season two, has it been spicier than season one?
Season two really did spice up our lives.
What was this experience like? I mean, it's very unique to be on a reality show like this. You have people that love the show, people that challenge the merits of the show. Is it everything that you hoped it would be being under this microscope?
You know, I have often thought about the answer to this question. It has been trying and stressful for sure. And, you know, especially for me, and if you are an avid watcher of our show, you see how things have, I usually am the brunt of a lot of ridicule, etc. But, you know what? On the other side of the spectrum, there's always two sides to a story. It's been wonderful for me for the different things that I've been doing with music and all of the humanitarian things that I've been able to have a bigger platform, for. So it's been great. And
nobody's smiling in these clips, though.
No, there's not a lot of reason to smile.
Well, you know, it's interesting. It asks people watching, there's your best friend, Jody, and I know there's plenty of stories with you, too. Oh, hello. Missed that episode.
You know, the one thing that continually is asked to me about our show is it scripted?
Mm.
And the truth of the matter is, it's not scripted.
No.
It is not scripted.
So Jody was here in the room right now. Not Jody Vance, but Jody Clayman. Is that the last name?
I think so, yeah. That's
right. If Jody was here in the room, what would that be like? Would it be tense or would it be okay?
You know, for me, yes, it'll be tense, but yeah. I just think it's ridiculous that she doesn't talk to me or she acts so childish and nasty. I just think life is too short for that.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know what she has against me, but anyway, I've stopped thinking about it. It doesn't matter anymore. Whatever she says, she says. Whatever Ronnie says, whatever anybody says, I don't, you know, I'm busy. I've got a full life. I'm happy. I've got wonderful children, so.
And, you know, there are many roles that you play. Mother of three, recording artist. What's more difficult, the idea of your music career, which has been showcased in the show, or the idea of being on a reality TV program?
You know, being on the show is really what you make of it, I think, right? So that's been, like, for me, it's been okay. I've just went into it being myself, and I knew that it was a platform for me, and I had a goal in mind when I did it, and I had no idea it was going to turn out the way it has with all the fighting and the arguing and all of that. And it's been hard on me, but, you know, at the end of the day, my music was something I did for me, and I was scrutinized when people listened to it. They liked it or they didn't, but now when you're on a show like ours, you're scrutinized just for being on it as much as you are for who you are.
It's always a double-edged sword with these types of things. You make a choice to go on the vehicle, but you've used your voice for good. I know you have raised some money for Friends for Life campaign, which is good.
Yeah.
The anti-bullying sentiments that come out. And I know this is going to be debuting on the Shopping Channel.
Yes.
Of course, one of my favorite topics, the smoky eye.
The smoky eye. You like the smoky eye.
Big fan of the smoky eye. And plump lips. Plump lips. That's where it's at, ladies.
Okay. Really. Here's the thing.
Yeah.
So the reason that I absolutely have been so excited about this, because it's like a dream for a girl to come up with a makeup line, right? I mean, it's amazing. I'm a creative person, and so anything in the arts I've always been very interested in. But Buff was conceptualized really because I've had so many people throughout the years ask me about what products I use, and I've always, you know, I think the older that I've become, the more I've realized that. You know, I used to be in that rat race of wanting to look a certain way and that everything had to be perfect, but it's not like that anymore for me. Like, I really believe that, you know, that there's only certain people who are universally so beautiful they can walk out of a magazine. But most of us are, you know, moms, and we're working, and we're rushing from here to there. And so I thought I wanted to create something that answers the questions for what I use, and I've had so many people ask me that, and these are the essential products that are my star products. So I went to a lab, and we organized it, and we figured out what my favorite products are, and that's what we came up with. And I called it Buff because it's natural. It's not, you know, makeup can be used as frosting on a cake, or you can use it just to enhance your natural beauty.
Mm-hmm.
And so this line was really created for that. And I've got five essential pieces that, you know, I used to have the makeup bag that was so jam-packed that I couldn't zip it.
Yeah.
So now I've just, you know, taken it all down to the essentials, and a lot of my products are dual purpose.
So we're going to leave that as the tease, because I know on the Shopping Channel next week you're going to be on there showcasing each and every one of these products. So we're going to have details on that on our Facebook page, and if you want to see more with with Mary Zilbaugh.
Can I see more?
Revive, Your Life Made Beautiful. Never seen you like this. Just a bed sheet, eh? That's it.
That's it. But it's all about the buff. It's a very long kind of interview with me. But yeah, I only wore a sheet for that.
We'll leave that up there.
And that comes out. April 8th, and I'm on the Shopping Channel April 12th, so everyone has to watch April 12th, four shows, and I'll be selling this collection, and I think everyone will love it. It's for the mom at home, for the student running out the door to work, and just to natural, understated, and pretty. And fresh.
Russ, I gotta say, man, April 12th, we should be watching this. We can look out
for
the ladies.
Thank you, Mary. That sounds like appointment viewing on April 12th.
Thank you.
I gotta remind you that that magazine's a sample. You can't take that home, okay? You gotta leave that one at the studio.